Hi, I'm Harry Forbes from ARC Advisory Group. My guest is Nathan Pettus, Process Systems President for Emerson. Nathan, welcome.
Thank you very much. Glad to be here.
Well, it's great to have you. One of the questions we've been hearing about, and certainly an area that's very hyped, is edge computing. I wouldn't think of Emerson first as edge computing company. So tell me a little bit about what you're doing in that space.
You know, it's interesting. Edge is a term that gets used a lot in the industry, as you say, and it means different things to different people. For us, I think it means making sure that the right software, the right intelligence is the right level of the hierarchy of the plant. So, you know, for years, Emerson has been moving smarts into the field through smart devices. We've been doing that for 2 decades. And now with our Aspen partnership, we really feel like we're the company that can provide the most flexibility to put those smarts and that data collection at the right place, close to the process when it needs to be, a little higher up when it needs to be. But in the end, it's bringing that information together through gateways. The edge gateway is typically what people are talking about. And the new standards like Mira Open Architecture are talking about how you take a DCS, which is really an edge system. It's where all the data comes together, and exposing that with context up to the cloud through an edge gateway. And we're working those kind of technologies every day.
Okay, another thing we've been hearing a lot about, especially yesterday here, was cybersecurity, and it's a rising concern for everybody in many industries now.
Absolutely.
What is going on with Emerson in that area?
Yeah, it's kind of a dichotomy, because on the one hand, people want to get data out through the edge gateway, but they want to make sure it's secure. For a long time in this industry, the way we managed security around cyber was to air gap, just keep things disconnected. But with the merger of cloud and IT and OT and digital transformation, it's just not possible, practical anymore. So what we've done is work with customers really on a 3-phase approach. Protect the system. So you put all of the virus protections and hardened switches and things you need to do to make the system as secure as possible. And then make sure you're maintaining that. Because if you're not doing constant patch management and making sure the software is secure perpetually, it won't do any good to protect it in the first place. And then with partnerships like Dragos, we're basically able to monitor that. So it's really a protect, maintain, and monitor. And that's a service and a philosophy that we've worked with successfully with a lot of customers to make sure they feel like they can get the data out, but in a very secure way.
Another topic we're hearing about is disruption, and we see some companies here that haven't been here in the past. And what kind of disruptive technologies and areas do you see on your radar for Emerson?
You know, I think the technologies you mentioned, edge and cyber, those are all trends. I think 5G and AI and machine learning and virtualization, all of those things, cloud, are all going to impact our industry. They already are. For sure they will. But to me, the technology that I see, or the trend that I see that is going to shift over the next decade or so, is just this further and further softwareization of the control systems and safety systems and merging those with the IT systems. That's really going to be something that I think is going to continue. It started virtualizing, and things are going to become more software centric, which will be a lot more powerful for our customers to take advantage of that data that they have. And I think that's the trend that I see is probably most likely to disrupt what has for a long time. And I grew up in this industry for 30 years. The systems were built around wiring, hardware, and those things are still important. But I think in time, what we're going to find is companies are going to come to market with software that can work almost on top of anyone's hardware.
I totally agree. You were talking earlier in the executive panel about innovation and creating a culture of innovation and promoting that. Can you talk a little bit about how that works within your firm?
Yeah, I really feel like, at least I tell myself this every day because I'm passionate about it, that bringing disruptive technologies to market in this industry or any industry is really how our standard of living as humans get better. And you know, in Emerson, we feel like we've done that through the last couple of decades. We brought a lot of technologies to bear that disrupted the market, but also sometimes even disrupted our current business. And I think that's really, really important. And we're going to continue to invest in that. We're increasing our R&D budget. We're driving a lot of investment throughout the organization to drive more innovation. And then we're also trying to instill a culture where everybody can innovate. You know, we talk about innovation a lot of times in the industry around technology, engineering, design, but every job, yours, mine, every job in a company can be done a little better tomorrow than it was yesterday. And that's an innovative culture that we want to foster, that everyone around the globe can innovate no matter where they are, no matter what function they're in, so that we can all be a little more productive tomorrow than we are today.
One thing we didn't talk about too much was services. And as we look at market research at ARC, we look in many of the markets, especially DCS market, are service intensive.
Yeah.
So what are your directions and kind of changes and innovations in the service part of the business, which is a critical part?
Yeah. I think the thing that we've seen, and you've probably seen too over the last 3 or 4 or 5 years, COVID made it even more prominent, is just the need for customers to have service offerings that are sort of outcome-based, or just take care of it. You just need to have this thing solved for me. We had a customer that had a drive the car program. And the initiative behind that was, I just, when I come out of my house in the morning, I get into my car, I put the key in, I turn it on, it drives away. That's what I want for my automation system. I want it to just be pain-free, and I want to work with you, Emerson, to ensure our automation system is, the service offering is around making sure it runs, having it available every single day, regardless of what needs to be done with it. So they would take those contracts on with us. And we're seeing that more and more with our customers. I mean, IT contracts in the world are really done around availability. And I think that is starting to come into our industry. So outcome-based services and making sure that you're there to provide an outcome and uptime and things like that are really what's different.
Okay. Another area that companies have had to make a transition is from kind of perpetual license models to subscription models for software and services. And that's been a difficult transition for a lot of companies, and the companies that have made it are happy. But what's going on with you guys there?
Yeah, you know, we're like everybody. I think some of our customers are asking for that. Some customers aren't as quick to ask for it. We were a little bit fortunate. Our Guardian platform, which is a platform that all of our customers, install-based customers, leverage to stay current, find out how their systems are running, has been a, call it, SaaS model for years. Mm-hmm. You basically log into a portal, you pay by a month, per month, and you use the software remotely. There's nothing installed. So we've got a history there that we're comfortable with extending with our customers, because as customers want to extend that, they can. But then we're also seeing we're bringing new products to market in a subscription-based way, even hardware solutions. So we've got a solution that we recently announced that will connect to other people's I/O and bring other people's control information into our system. And used to, we would probably charge a certain amount, one-time fee for the box. Mm-hmm. And now it's a yearly subscription to keep that service running. So that's a very different way to bring the same solution. It's still hardware, software, and services, but it's bundled in a subscription. And we've even got customers now even asking us to talk about how they might do a subscription for the entire system. So turn it from a CapEx to an OpEx kind of a commercial model, which is, you know, something we're excited to try to do. But to your point, it's varying degrees of readiness.
Okay, well, thanks a lot for being with us, Nathan. I really appreciate your time and insight.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
This is Harry Forbes from ARC Advisor Group. My guest has been Nathan Pettus. He is the President for Process Automation of Emerson. Thanks.